In the profession of taking care of others, Rachel Watkins is learning to take care of herself.
Being able to ask for help was a big lesson that I improved on. I've learned how to adapt to change.
The past year since COVID first hit the DMV has been a ride full of bumps and turns. But as the nursing director at MedStar Washington, Watkins knows she can't unbuckle her seatbelt just yet.
Unit 4C is still full with COVID patients, so we are still pretty busy and don't feel a break right now.
A break is what they all need. It's been challenging fighting the front lines of a pandemic when stress and emotions are attacking them.
It's sad that it's gone on this long, and I remember the anxiety and anticipation on my unit when we were going to get that first patient.
It's a long list of people who died in the hospital's critical care unit.
Hundreds of patients, unfortunately, have died of this.
Dr. Alexandra Pratt says her team has taken care of more than 800 COVID-19 patients since March. Nowadays, cases on her plate are going down.
What really hurt was just how random and senseless this really felt in many cases. I think the hardest thing was when families couldn't be at the bedside when their loved ones were dying.
The past year has forced the hospital to think fast, coming up with a system to help with capacity by transforming any room into an intensive care unit by using remote monitoring and using a telemedicine tool to connect families with patients.
I think we've learned a lot about how to be flexible and how to be innovative in real time, and I think we'll carry those lessons with us.
They do see an end to this battle against an invisible enemy, as long as they say everyone else will fight along with them.
I am so adamant about people getting the vaccine because I just don't want to see people in this situation.
Dr. Pratt is shocked that there are states lifting mask mandates when she says the pandemic is still raging. The majority of her patients are still coming from Black and Hispanic communities, but lately she's seeing patients coming in with other illnesses who incidentally have COVID as well. Reporting in Northwest, I'm Matthew Torres, WUSA 9.